How y'all doing? It's your girl, nothing but triple 12 20, and I'm here today to answer a GlamNERDS question. Shout out to everyone who sent in a question in response to the video. I'm getting to them. One by one, I promise you I'm going to answer your question. Just continue to ride with me. Today's question is coming from Felecia over at Little Women 1 on YouTube. Felecia sent a question in about differences between independent and dependent status on the FAFSA. Like, can she claim to be an independent person? And I'm not going to get all into her business because this is the World Wide Web, and I don't want to put all her family affairs on there. But I'm going to talk about what a student would need in order to claim him or herself as an independent student on the FAFSA. So stay tuned. A lot of people feel as though when they turn 21, they are independent. I know I did. But in terms of the FAFSA, in terms of the U.S. Financial Aid Department of Division of the Department of Education, there are specific criteria that one would need to meet in order to be considered an independent adult. That just means that when you're independent, you are just including your income information on your FAFSA. You would not have to include, because when you're a dependent student, you have to include, I'm sorry, I'm all in my face, your parents' information. Everyone who's in the household's income information has to be included on your FAFSA. That's your mom, your dad, your grandma, if she lives with you, your Uncle Pete. You got an older brother named Riri, and he work over at the Burger King. His stuff needs to be on your FAFSA, because the FAFSA uses household income, not just family, household income, to assess your estimated family contribution. In order to be considered an independent person, in which nobody else but your income information is listed on your FAFSA, you have to meet some very specific criteria established by the Department of Education, United States federal government. The first things first, if you are married, then you're an independent. You can file independently. If you're married on the day you file your FAFSA, you cannot file your, like, if I'm engaged and I'm filling out my FAFSA now, I have to file as a dependent if I'm still staying with my mother. I cannot be dependent until I'm legally married. I don't care if the ceremony has taken place, but we just haven't signed the license. I'm legally married, then I'm an independent person, but I would still have to include my spouse's income. So if you're enrolled in a master's or doctoral program at the beginning of your school year, you can file independently. If you are at least 24 years old on the day you file your FAFSA, a lot of people think it's 21 because you can drink and you're grown. Not so much. According to FAFSA people, you have to be 24 years old on the day you file your FAFSA in order to claim independent status, provided you don't meet any of the following criteria I'm about to list. If you are a parent, and that also has a loophole. So if you're a parent and it's just you and your child living in an apartment somewhere, then you can file independently. But if you are a parent and you still live with your mother or your grandmother or some other person who is claiming you and your child on their income taxes, you are not an independent student. I'm so sorry. If you have dependents, again, if you are a self-sufficient adult and you have dependents other than a spouse who live with you, this could be if you're caring for a parent or grandparent or aunt or uncle who, you know, is staying with you and you're claiming them on your income taxes, and if they receive more than half of their support from you at the time of your application to the FAFSA, then you're an independent person. If both of your parents were deceased prior to you turning 18 years old and you were at any point a ward of the state in which you reside, then you can claim an independent status. You are currently serving on active duty in the U.S. Armed Forces for any reason aside from basic training, then you can file independently. If you're a veteran of the U.S. Armed Forces, you can file independently. If you were a foster child between the ages of 13 and 18, you can file independently. If you're an emancipated child, or you've been, you know, a court judge emancipated you, or you divorced your parents, in other words, then you can file independently. And also, if you're homeless, and that homelessness can be determined or confirmed by the director of a HUD approved homeless shelter or transitional program, or in your high school, if they can confirm that you were homeless or are homeless at the time of your application, then you can file independent status as well. If none of the above listed criteria apply to you, then you're a dependent student, even if your IRS tax status is different, even if you have no idea where your parents are. Like, I don't live with my father. When I was a freshman and filing for my FAFSA, I had no earthly idea where he was. But because I didn't meet any of these other criteria, I could not include his information because I didn't have it, but I could not list myself as an independent person. Felecia, I hope this answered your question. Again, I didn't want to be too long-winded, but if you have any further questions or if there's anything else that I can do, please, please, please do not hesitate. Oh, child, get into my scarf. So let me just tell y'all the truth about this hat. Because I was getting ready to take me a good old nap because I'm tired. But then I realized that I did not record this video. So instead of unwrapping my hair, I just threw this hat on since I hadn't washed my face. I was like, oh, I can be cute and all accessorized. But now, since you saw my scarf for the majority of the video, I might as well be keep it all the way 100. I'm sorry if I was confusing or I wasn't as clear as possible. And please let me know if you need me to further expound on anything that I have said. So again, shout out to Felecia. Thank you so much for sending in your question. And I will get to each question as soon as I can. I promise you have my word. In the meantime, y'all keep it locked. Keep checking GlamNERDS.com. Share this video forward. If you follow me on Twitter, I'll post my Twitter right there. Every time there's a new post, I tweet about it. Retweet that, share it. There's a Facebook fan page. I also include that link over there in the sidebar. So if you have any further questions or want to reach out to us in any way, we'd be more than happy to oblige you. Until next time. Bye!